We also had a chance to talk about the economy, issues, order, amount of trade, how much that takes place back and forth, and how we continue to build on some of the work that we've done. We are both soon to be signatories to the TPP agreement, and that's another area where we can continue to have important discussions. I know Justin has to review what's happened, but do you think that after that process has taken place, that Canada, the United States, and other countries that are here can establish the kind of high standards agreement that protects the environment, protects the environment, protects the kind of high value goods and services that
I've always been very, very clear. Canada will and must remain a strong member of the coalition against ISIL. And that means humanitarian aid, that means support on refugees, and it also means engaging militarily. There is much that Canada can do, and Canada will continue to work with our coalition partners to ensure that we're doing what we can, including militarily, to degrade and defeat ISIL over the long haul. That's what I reassured the President about, and that's what we're going to continue to be engaged in. And I'm going to be discussing further the best ways Canada can move forward. But I made a clear commitment to Canadians to withdraw the 6 fighter jets, and we will be doing that in collaboration and coordination with all of our allies to ensure that the coalition still has tremendous impact against ISIL. First phone call that we had, I don't dwell on the gray hair because there's nothing I can do about that, but what Barack pointed out to me about how fast his daughters grew in the 7 years since that first night of his electoral victory really struck home for me. I'm making sure to try and remain as attentive and present for my kids, not just because it makes me a better parent and a better person, but also because it's what keeps us focused as leaders on what actually matters, how we build a better world for our kids.
Right now in Alberta, a lot of the issues with respect to hard extract oil, which have to do with the fact that oil prices are low, and they're going to be low, I suspect, more than one. And that actually presents both our countries an opportunity. With respect to producers, it's a good time to think about how you diversify your business model. With respect to consumers, it's a good time to think about how are you using the savings you may make at the pump for installing a solar panel on your house and continuing to benefit from these low prices, not to use more, but to shift how you spend your energy. This is going to be a messy, bumpy process worldwide. But I am confident that we can get it done. And in fact, we have a very strong partner in Canada to help set up some global rules on how we approach this. I think we'll be able to work on it. All right. Thank you.